Welcome back to my channel. Today we continue forces and function 1 on topic 2.4 initial part 2. So in this video, I will discuss on the third learning standard, that is justify the effects of inertia in daily life. So before we discuss further about the effects of inertia in daily lives, if you still remember, in my first video, I have discussed about inertia balance. We have discussed experiment 2.2, where we can see the hacksaw blade or the jigsaw blade can be used to determine unknown mass. Meaning by using the period of oscillation, we can use the inertial balance to determine the mass of an unknown object. So this is how the astronaut in a spaceship such as in ISS, when they want to measure the weight, they are using this method. The periods of oscillation of astronaut are used to determine their body mass. Now you observe this video. This is how they use the inertial balance. You can see that from here, this is the inertial balance. From the period of oscillation recorded throughout the oscillation, they can determine their weight. As you know, at the spaceship, there's more or very weak gravity force, so we cannot determine the actual weight of the astronaut. So by using this method, you can determine the weight. Okay. So daily life situation that involve inertia and its effect. So we are going to discuss about the positive effect and negative effect. For negative effect, we want to discuss the method how to reduce the effect of inertia. So look at situation 1. Raindrops spun off when a wet umbrella is rotated and suddenly stopped. Maybe you have tried this before, so you can see all the water droplets on the umbrella will be sprinkled away when you rotate the umbrella and stop it suddenly. So this is the concept of inertia. When we use concept of inertia to explain, you must add in the explanation involving inertia. Raindrops on the umbrella are in motion as umbrella rotates. When the umbrella stops rotating, meaning sudden stop, the inertia of the raindrops causes the raindrops to continue in motion and leave the surface of the umbrella. Meaning the umbrella already stopped, but the droplets has inertia will continue moving, thus sprinkle away from the umbrella. Okay. Second situation, passengers are thrown backwards when a bus at rest suddenly starts moving forward. So you see moving forward, but the body of the passenger moves backward. So we want to explain this using concept of inertia. This is what happened when the bus moving suddenly stopped. You can see the body of the passenger look like thrown forward. So this one we call it effect of inertia. So inertia of the passengers keeps them in their initial state of rest or motion. For this one, starts to moving forward. At first, or initially, the passenger's body are at rest. When the bus suddenly move forward, inertia of the passenger still remain in a state of rest, thus move backward. And this one also, when the bus suddenly stop, initially the passengers is moving with the bus, moving forward. When the bus stop suddenly, inertia of the passenger still maintain a motion of moving forward, thus their body thrown forward. Okay, so you must be able to explain a situation by using concept of inertia. Third situation, you can get the tomato sauce out of a bottle by shaking it up and down and stop it suddenly. Okay, so this is also a concept of inertia. So chili sauce or tomato sauce in a bottle flow out when the glass is moved quickly downwards and then suddenly stop. The inertia of the sauce causes it to continue moving downwards and out of the bottle. Okay, so initially moving downward, when suddenly stop, the sauce is continue moving due to its inertia. Okay, so this is the beneficial part of the concept of inertia. Okay, situation 4. you can see this oil tanker trucks have large inertia because carry large amount of oil in the tank. In fact, an oil tanker truck has its storage tank divided into several separate tanks. Instead of using one large tank, it divides it to a few small tanks. So how this one can reduce the effect of inertia? Can you imagine if you use one large tank, suddenly the lorry stops suddenly. So the effect of inertia caused by the large tanks is greater. So maybe that large tank will move forward and hit the driver. So that one is very dangerous. But so when divided to a smaller tanks, so each of the tank will have its own inertia. So the inertia of each tank is smaller compared to one large tank. Thus the effect can be reduced. So the separated tank reduce the impact of inertia of the petrol. So this is one method to reduce the negative effect of inertia. So inertia will cause positive or negative effects to the objects. Certain methods can be applied to reduce negative effect of inertia. Remember, inertia cannot be reduced, but the effects of inertia can be reduced. Okay. Situation 5, this is a roller coaster. Riders on the roller coaster in a recreation park are assigned to sit through a specialized safety system. Okay. The roller coaster carriage moves at sudden change of speed and direction. So when this happens, means their body keeps moving forward, backward, okay, due to the change in the speed and direction. So the safety features that requires for the roller coasters, when the carriage of the roller coaster changes its direction suddenly, inertia of the riders keeps them in their original state of motion. The safety system ensures the riders remain in their seats and not thrown out during the motion. There's a safety belt required or something like a features that can hold them at their place without being thrown forward. So that one is the safety system for the roller coaster. Okay, situation 6, seat belt. Or safety belt. Driver and passengers of a car are advised to wear seat belt. Why? When a car stops abruptly, meaning suddenly stop, the driver and passengers in the car are thrown forward because of inertia. Seat belts prevent them from being thrown forward and hurting themselves. Okay, so seat belt is one of the method to reduce negative effect of inertia. Safety features means a reduced effect of inertia for this topic. Okay. So let's look at formative practice 2.4. Number 1, explain the concept of inertia. So inertia is the tendency of an object to remain at rest or if moving to continue its motion in a straight line at uniform velocity unless acted upon by external force. So that one is the explanation of concept of inertia. Number 2, Brian wishes to pull a tablecloth without toppling the things on top of the tablecloth. How can Brian do it? Explain your answer. Okay. The first thing, there is something that you need to make sure is the table and the cloth must be smooth. Okay, if not, maybe that one will prevent the tablecloth to move faster. So that no friction, and Brian must pull the cloth with jerk. Pull it faster. If he pull with jerk, inertia of the things on top will remain in state of rest and not move along with the cloth. So this is the method. Okay. Number 3, study the following statements. Statement 1, objects can continue moving only if a force acts on them. Statement 2, rockets in outer space can move without any engine thrust. Statement 3, force is required to change the state of motion of the objects. Remember, we have discussed before the concept of inertia. There must be no external force. Meaning either the object remains at rest is just due to its natural properties that we call inertia, or the object continue moving also due to its natural properties that we call inertia. There's no external force. Okay, statement one clearly stated a force act. So this one is not concept of inertia or Newton's first law of motion. Newton's first law of motion is also known as law of inertia. Okay, statement two, rockets in outer space can move without any engine thrust, meaning no external force. Statement three, force is required to change the state of motion of objects. So this one very clearly we can see force applied. So statement one and three cannot be explained using Newton's first law of motion. So only statement two. Okay. B, give reason of your choice. The rocket moved in outer space due to effect of inertia, as there was no external force acted on it. This situation is applicable to Newton's first law of motion. So you want to apply Newton's first law of motion or law of inertia, you need to ensure that the situation involved external force is zero, meaning no external force act on the object. Okay. So I think for this topic, 2.4 inertia, we have done for this one. So I hope you can go and search more on the negative effects of inertia and method to reduce it, because this one can come out in essay question or paper 2 question. Okay, so that's all for today. Bye.